some spooky music. Hey guys, it's Kevin here. Today we're going to have a look at Clive Barker's Undying. I know nothing about this game. I have not looked it up, I've not done anything. Although I have just I have to apologise in advance. There doesn't seem to be any subtitle options. So I've turned the volume up, but I'm going to have to mess about with it so you can still hear my lovely dulcet tones. Let's have one more look. I don't see any subtitles. Let's just get on with this. Like I said, know nothing about this. I've not looked it up at all. Let's just have a wee look. I'm tired of traveling or fighting superstition. I'll move the speaker closer to the microphone.
Even though it was me who chose to debunk folklore and mysticism, little did I know I'd end up being labeled as Patrick Galloway, the man with endless occult knowledge. Before I knew it, people all over the world paid me to investigate all kinds of weird things. As long as they paid me, I'd look into it. Funny thing, though, the more I saw, the more I believe there are forces beyond our control. Creatures not explainable in any human terms. Things that make my skin crawl. I fled from Ireland and hung around Paris and London with no real purpose till the Great War started. I joined a special unit whose job it was to squelch the fears of the superstitious farm boys who made up the fighting ranks. The Tresanti were the biggest pains. New commanding officer, Jeremiah Covenant, led our unit on the hunt for their camp. We were ambushed. They came streaming out of the woods, waving swords and howling like banshees. I saw their leader holding a strange stone over his head, yelling weird words in a strange tongue. And just when he was gonna pull the trigger, he glared right at me. A bright green flash came from his hand, and it bowled me over as my gun went off. I woke up in a hospital bed with severe burns. They told me Jeremiah and the unit had gone on without me, but he'd given me the shaman stone to keep. I hadn't given any of this much thought until I came back here to find this letter that Jeremiah wrote me almost 6 months ago, asking me to come back to Ireland and help him out. This is not something I'm dying to do, for it may mean the death of me. He saved my life, though, so I owe it to him. Just hope it's not too late.
Right. Oh, first person game. I've got a stone. Looks like a sponge. Right, let's do this. Can I shoot the bats? Whoa! What was this? Whoa! Get in here then.
I'm Patrick Galloway, a friend of Jeremiah's. Sorry it took me so long to get here. His letter said it was most urgent.
Jeremiah was beginning to think that the letter never arrived in your hands. He's been quite anxious to see you. We've all been quite worried. Jeremiah.
Awkward pause.
Follow me and I'll show you to his living quarters. I apologize for the look of the house, but there's only a skeleton for your servants now.
It seems fine to me. I wouldn't pass out. Whoa.
And the house is much too large for us.
Whoa! There are demonic people here.
Because we've lost electricity to most parts of the house, we can only maintain the living quarters.
She's got quite a stride on her.
This family's had so much tragedy.
Pladdity?
I hope you can help him.
I'm going to have a quick
Stuck.
I was about to say I was going to have a quick explore, but it's stuck. Might need to change the mouse sensitivity. Oh, yeah. It's Conan O'Brien. Voldo from... Whoa! Okay, I'll admit that got me. I kept my cool, though. That's all that matters. Okay, that's quite a lot of loading screens.
Patrick, you made it.
He's got quite a swagger.
Jeremiah. Sorry for the delay, but I've been abroad. What happened to you?
It seems I've come under the watchful eye of the Reaper, my friend.
Oh, the Reapers.
It's been a long time,
hasn't it? Shepard.
Apparently too long.
Patrick, I came back from the war only to find my entire estate in disarray. My brother Aaron disappeared first, and then my sister Bethany. My declining health is a result of an old war wound, and unfortunately, the symptoms are irreversible. I didn't summon you here to watch me die.
Oh, by the way, I saw a fucking ghost in the corridor.
Strange events began happening around the manor. After thinning out my staff, they ransacked my estate, taking whatever they could carry. The rest of the help was quick to follow, as they feared rumors of my family's curse. I can't help but think it's more than a coincidence. It's strange how...
Oh, it's Conan O'Brien on the right.
...since I've been back from the war. I want to get to the bottom of this.
That's a nice family portrait. You know, that's... They look like nice people.
I'm relying on you to step in for me.
Of course, Jeremiah. The only reason I was coming back here is to assist you however I can.
My thanks to you, Patrick.
What the hell was that?
Sounds like it came from downstairs.
I'll check it out. Lock the door behind me.
Right, oh, I've got a journal. Oh, how do I view it? I'm gonna check this door first.
Stuck.
Two weapons. This wasn't. Oh, Conan! You alright? You gonna do another Clueless Gamer episode? Alright.
Jammed.
That's pretty funny, I suppose. I can understand why he's laughing. This seems to be some sort of spectral world? I don't know. It's something. I don't really. I don't even know how to check my journal. Another loading screen. I was thinking maybe the loading screens were just for cutscenes, but I guess it's just for going into different areas as well. Whoa! Showing off, are we? Nothing bad's gonna happen if I look in this mirror. Oh! I haven't played this before, and I'm being a smartass. I honestly didn't know that would happen. It's quite silly, but quite fun. Oh, is this our first enemies? Oh, whoa, whoa! I'll take your time. Alright, let's try this thing out. Boo! Boo! Whoa! Oh, it's not working. Oh, I'm not doing very well. Whoa! I seem to have infinite bullets. No, I don't have infinite bullets. I've got at the bottom left, I can see. Whoa! Okay, that's enough messing around. Can I reload? Maybe if I change weapon. Nope. Okay, again, you'll need to forgive me. I'm going to have a quick look at controls. Alright, so, Duck, okay, jump. Next bit, mouse wheel, I already know that. Alright, how about reload? I thought I just saw reload. Oh, there's a face! That wasn't always there, was it? That's dumb. But I like it, I like dumb. Whoa, whoa, whoa! Is that the same one? I think we've found our common foot soldiers for the game. What? 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 Ah. Okay. I've not did that before. I'm a bit OCD about just checking every door. Stop showing off, you're clearing up.
Can you describe what you can only see? As the bonds of flesh are broken, the world becomes apparent.
Sure, right. Did I just go the wrong way? I thought those other doors are locked, right? Oh, hello. Is this a different area? No, no, it's not. This is where the spooky ghost comes and goes. Where? Oh yeah, someone's dying now. Oh. That seems okay. It controls well enough. Where's this last one? Whoa! Ah! Oh, shot that one in the head. Oh, it's taking cover. Clever girl. There we are. There's another one through here. This is the one that ate my fucking head. Oh, some good shooting. She's dead now. Whoa! That's quite a face. Oh, is that my footprint? Oh! Oh, come on, Kevin! Here we go. That's how you do it. How do I reload? How do I go in my inventory? I'll try press I. Nothing. I'm just gonna press a bunch of. Oh! Whoa! Sorry, wrong button. I'll just get on with it for now. Oh, he doesn't see me. Come on, he's a bit sensitive. Oh! Oh! Am I Patrick? Can't remember. Buddy? Just make sure everything's clear first. Another cutscene.
Those beasts were after me.
What in God's name were those things?
They're called howlers. And while I've never seen one before tonight, I've heard of them for years.
Those weren't natural, my friend. We're fighting more than superstitions here.
Perhaps I was being naive not to tell you, but there might be something more sinister at work here. When I was a boy, I encountered something I can't quite explain. You see, there was this isle of standing stones that sits just off the estate. Someone had carved a sigil into each of the stones. Something indiscernible. Father had many books on the occult, one of which contained a sketch of them. Very simple. I took my brothers and sisters out to the island and read from my father's book. Well, what happened? Something answered. The ocean began to boil, and a great wind whipped against us as we stood in the circle, and my siblings huddled to the ground in fear. Eventually, the wind died, and the sea settled. Patrick, I know it sounds like the ravings of a dying man,
but I believe those standing stones had something to do with this. What has once been a taint upon this family has now begun to manifest itself.
But you told me you're dying. Doesn't this curse end with you?
Who knows? My brothers and sisters are dead.
Just push him in the fire. When his back's turned, just that should end it.
Elizabeth on the estate. My family has come for me. I sense them, Patrick. By now, you and I know the supernatural exists.
Just push him in the fire.
And what about our encounters with the Tersante during the war? You still even carry the Gelzebar stone with you.
It's a token of the Shaman's life I took. That's all.
I found a scroll with a picture of the Gelzebar.
It's not. I clearly just used it earlier. Come on, mate.
It contains the way to awaken the stone's dormant power.
Very well. Let me study this scroll overnight, and I'll see what I can do in the morning.
This house still hides many secrets. I'm counting on you to reveal them and put an end to this mess.
Next. Oh, so I've slept. Whoa. Go. So I still don't really know how to, like, check my inventory or whatever. Is it here? No. Tab. Shift. Oh dear. I should be wrapping up this video soon anyway. Let's just have a wee explore. Another. There we are. That's a bit annoying. Yeah.
Have you noticed anything strange going on?
And who the fuck are you?
Elizabeth's room was broken into last night during the commotion.
Elizabeth?
Where's her room?
Not her.
Just down the hall from here. It's quite a mess.
I don't like him.
Won't budge.
What would happen? No, he's fine.
Tell me what you know about Liz.
Oh, I can control the camera, okay.
Why, she was a fetching young lass. Quite the fiery temper, though. She could be placid and calm 1 minute, and then suddenly she spit and curses.
I'm listening. I'm still listening.
Tis a pity her mother died birth in her.
Indeed.
Following her mother's death, I'd raise Lisbeth like my own. In the end, her wasting sickness got her. I'd care for her when she was sick and watched her wither away to nothing. Pity a young woman has to die in the spring of her life. Now she rests with her poor mother at the family mausoleum. The groundskeeper claims to have seen her recently. Poor man, seen her.
It's not creepy at all.
Where can I find this groundskeeper?
He's out in the gardens. You can get there through the kitchen.
Your knowledge is appreciated. Thank you.
Now die! All right. Can I talk to people? Oh. Those are some fine bitches. Sorry, it's a bad joke. Don't know why I told it. Not entirely sure where to go. They love their mirrors! Again.
Help me!
What? I'm trying. Where are they? Oh, hello. Oh, she's dead. Jesus. We got to work fast on her face. Right, I'll see what's going on in the next area, then I should probably wrap it up there. Oh! Piss you, buddy! I'd love to use a health... I'd love to use a health kit, but I don't know how. You alright? You alright? Alright. Right, okay, that'll do it. Right, well, this is Clive Barker's Undying. What do you guys think? I'm not sure yet, I might play a bit more. Okay, just later. Boom!